We got a lot, so we got to get her out. We got to get breakfast, and we got to get moving. Hello, my lovely little girl. Say, wake up, Alon. Say, wakey, wakey.
Don't say some bacon.
And there isn't any bacon. Oh, man. We living a... Ooh, we need to get our best life back together.
We are pulling out our radishes. This is what Jackson has so far.
So we let them in for like... So when we were going to pull them, we didn't see any radishes at first, except for this one. So we pulled out one and we like left these in for a week to see if they would grow. And this is what we got. I'm not sure if how I'll find any more, but I'm going to keep looking. Could you hold this for a second?
I think we need a...
More tiny radishes. These are hilarious. I think they're still growing.
They're already past their due dates.
Yeah, I know that. Go away, dirt.
So it's raining out here and the kids are coming out to get the, no, Bubba, you have to turn it upside down. Over. And put the things inside so it doesn't, yes, and put the white things inside so it doesn't flip around. Thank you, sister. We have a tropical storm off the coast of South Carolina, which we think that this is what's happening here. And yeah, just leave them out here. Put your hanger or something.
At least the plants are in the water.
Or throw it over here, Jack.
Yeah, at least the plants are getting good water.
Plants are getting some good water. Y'all, our garden is doing extremely well. We feel very blessed to be able to have... You're getting me wet.
Sorry.
Yes, there are two peppers on three of the pepper plants.
There's and more than
giant.
Two.
They are giant.
No, I mean, like that you can say.
Oh, cool. So I've got it for down here. I've got to get one of those things that we put there so it doesn't run the dirt off. I was kind of hoping the yard guy would come this week and mow, but gonna rain for the next couple days, so I don't think he's gonna come and mow. Hey, y'all, get a couple trash bags. We've got to keep this from getting wet. And we may need to move it over a little bit, too, just because. Well, it has balls inside of it. Get a couple trash bags to wrap this up, please. Anyway... I was sitting at my desk and I saw the umbrella rise up out of the table. Remember, I don't have a good granny. I don't have a base for it. That rain is coming down. You can't see it, but man. So I had sister run out and to take it out and just lay it on the ground because I think it hit the ground. It hit the house last time and it did put a hole in my siding, so I have a guy that's gonna fix the siding for me, but it did run up, come up out of the table and hit the house. So anyway, here, just open these. We should have got another tarp and just put it over top of this.
Wait, is it need to be open?
No, open it like that. Oh. But we gotta find a way to hold it down though. Maybe sit her chain on top of it. So at least it has kind of a weight on top of it.
What did I put on this?
The chain part. It's just the motor part that I'm concerned about, Jackson. The heavy chain part is the part that I'm asking.
Which one's the heavy one?
This is the chain along.
Okay, but some of the chain is connected.
Well, you can unconnect it. Anyway, I just thought I'd come out. We do, our deer netting is kind of sloping a little, so I'm going to come out and work in the garden a little bit this weekend and kind of just, I do want to weed around where the weed barrier is not, weeds are growing up, and I'm going to learn how to use a weed eater so that I don't have high grass growing up in the places that the yard guy can't cut because of the garden. We did okay with the weed barrier, but we didn't know that our We didn't realize, I think, that our garden was going to go so long. And so we didn't put enough weed barrier in. But that's okay. You live and you learn. This year was a good year. Alana came out and harvested lettuce yesterday. So our lettuce bucket is a little less. Our zucchini look great. They had kind of transplant shock at the very beginning, but they look very good now. Our cucumbers, Jack, look at the cucumbers. They have flowers.
Oh, yeah.
Look, y'all, I'll show you if I can get close. See, there are yellow flowers on the cucumbers. They are starting to grab onto the trellis and climb, but they're also climbing out of the bin. So, wow, that's awesome and exciting. But the garden's doing good. So we're thankful for all of that. I just wanted to show y'all this rain. That's our watermelon plant, which is actually taking off. And then this is also a watermelon plant right there as well. That's watermelon and watermelon right there. We'll be able to harvest carrots. Supposed to harvest carrots this week. Today, actually. So we'll see how they look. Those are carrots right there. Right there, carrots. Alana harvested the lettuce right there. We have a little lettuce here. These are onions. And then some more beans. And then those are beans and cucumbers. So, anyway, a lot happening. Our other beans, we have cucumbers and beans on the same tub. Next year, we'll do something totally different. I am thinking about just doing total kiddie pool gardens next year. We'll see how that works out as opposed to building the raised beds, because I want to be able to have the flexibility of moving the garden around. This is where I get the most sun on this side of the house, and I'm okay with that, which everything we planted needs sun. But anyway, we'll see. Tomatoes, we do have tomatoes on the tomato plant. Our grapevine has not taken off like I thought it would just yet. But again, it's early. We're just going to leave it there and see what happens. But I do want to come out in the garden and do some work this weekend and see how things are shaping up and show you guys. All right, you guys. So I've been working. Came in the kitchen and they did a cook ahead. Now I am gonna get them to double this recipe. So we'll actually have triple of these. These are bagels. And this is the, I think it's low carb yums recipe using coconut flour instead of the almond flour. And we just used a donut pan. And so I just got them to make these. I gave Alana the recipe so that we could have some of those bagels cooked ahead. But they cooked up so nicely. Look at how actually nice they cooked, that I want her to double this recipe so that we'll have at least 12 to 18 of these. That'll be a week's worth. And so I bought some cheese and we used coconut flour. So we had some of that on hand. So I'm going to get her to recreate this again. And then I went over to a food line. Jackson needed a few more things because he was trying to cook bagged beans at 6:30 last night. And that wasn't going to work for me. So I got him some canned beans, black beans, navy beans. We got kidney beans and great northern beans just to let him see what he likes. I picked up him some rice-a-roni. This is broccoli and cheddar. They had the chicken kind, which I thought would be better than the cheese, but he's not doing meat, so I didn't want to give him that flavor, so I just got that one. Some Parmesan cheese to go with this yolk for wide egg noodle, and then we got almond milk for Alon. Mom needed coffee creamer, French fried onions, and I got that for Jackson to go on top of his potatoes because he can have potatoes. And then I got this veggie hash browns. This is with carrots and bell peppers. So he can do that as well. Now, with that being said, this is really neat, you guys. So look at this. This is an electric can opener. I got this from Kitchen Mama. So the one thing that I like about this, because Jackson's going to have to open up these cans. You guys see
how that's going to have to happen. Because with him going vegetarian, mom is not doing the things. He has to do it. Now, I will help him, but he has to do the things. So I'm going to get him to come over and we're going to test out this can opener. Because what we have as our regular can opener is, you know, this is what we have, right? We've got the Hamilton Beach. Now listen, we ain't sleeping on Hamilton because we've had this for a long time. But it's the plug-in, you know, you got a plug-in. It's pretty large in comparison to the Kitchen Mama, right? So if you look at it, this has no plugs, right? No plugs. It's battery operated. There's four AA batteries in here, and this is how you control it. So we're going to test out how this works, and I think it's easy enough that even an 11-year-old can work it. So let me get his can washed off, or let him get his can washed off. Which one do you want? Black or navy? Okay, wash that off. Jackson's going to wash that off, and we're going to show you how easy it is to use this Kitchen Mama electric can opener. So in our normal, you know, we would have to lift this, hold the can,
stick it on,
clamp it down. Hopefully it takes the magnet, and then you, you know, do that. With the Kitchen Mama, you take the can opener, and you sit it on top of the can. Right, so you've got the little guide, and then the blade is on this side over here, and then Jackson's just going to hold it and hit the button, and it's going to work its way around the can. Looks like that might be it.
That's funny.
And then we're going to remove the can. Let's see.
What did it do?
There we go. Look.
Wow.
And it comes right off. Look at that. Because at first I was like, that didn't cut nothing. But you can see where the teeth sunk into the top and it cut around the side. So your can top comes off just like that. It doesn't have those little prickly sides where you would have from this normal regular can opener. And an 11-year-old can use it. So grab that, Jack. Look at that. An 11-year-old. What'd you think, 11-year-old?
I guess it'd be safer for kids because there's no spiky teeth. It was pretty easy, though.
Pretty easy and portable, right? So he can take this to any part of the kitchen that he's in. No, doesn't have to plug anything in like the you know, traditional. Nothing wrong with that, but we do like this. Look at that, you guys. That's awesome. Loving that. So if you're interested in that, listen, here's what you can do. Head down to the description box below. You will see a link for this electric can opener. I have a code, Shakema10, that will get you 10% off. And you can follow them if you're interested. You can follow them on Facebook at Kitchen Mama. You can follow them on Instagram at Kitchen Mama US. Facebook is also Kitchen Mama US. So if you're interested in that, there it is. We are sold on that. And it just takes four AA batteries. So there it is. Praise the Lord. Alrighty, you guys. So I want to apologize to you right up front because for some reason, I lost one of the clips that is supposed to be on the end of that video, on the end of the video when Jackson and I were in the kitchen doing the demonstration of the Kitchen Mama. I don't know where it went, but it is gone. But anyway, we just wanted to show you that small little haul. I wanted to show you that kitchen can opener. We love that thing. Jackson actually has used it several times. It's good enough for a young kid to use. There's nothing that I'm worried about him cutting his hand. No plugs, just takes four AA batteries. And again, there will be a link in the description box below and a code for 10% off if anybody is interested in the Kitchen Mama electric can opener. Love, love, love that. So anywho, thank you all so much for stopping by, y'all. I'm so sorry that I lost that clip. What's happening is I'm filming several videos at the same time.
And I don't do that very well because for some reason, I always kind of get like what video clip goes with what clip. And what I should be doing is putting them into the editing software all along. And I'm trying to get better at that, but I did lose a tiny clip. So if you guys would forgive me, I would appreciate that. Thank you all so much again for just stopping by and hanging out with us. We do appreciate that. We love you guys and we'll see you next time. Bye now.